good news, always good news, good news, good news, there is good news today.
No matter what else is happening in the world,
always good news, good news.
There is always good news today. Welcome to Good News Today, the program where you will always find good news, no matter what else is happening in the world. I'm Jim Dearman, your host for Good News Today. Thanks for joining us once again here in the Good News Room. Let me tell you what's coming up on today's program. Our devotional time today features the scripture from Psalm 37, the first 11 verses of that 37th Psalm. That will be our scripture reading and our study scripture, of course, after our singing segment, that is part of our devotional time. Again, thanks so much for joining us. We hope you have your Bibles open and that you're ready to read along now from Psalm 37, the first 11 verses, a psalm attributed to David. "Do not fret," he writes, "because of evildoers, nor be envious of the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and feed on His faithfulness. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and He shall give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in Him, and He shall bring it to pass. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Do not fret because of him who prospers in his way, because of the man who brings wicked schemes to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Do not fret, it only causes harm. For evildoers shall be cut off, but those who wait on the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. For yet a little while, and the wicked shall be no more. Indeed, you will look carefully for his place, but it shall be no more. But the meek shall inherit the earth and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace."
Since the love of God has shed priceless blessings on my head,
back for the study portion of our devotional time. Psalm 37, we're looking at the first 11 verses. And really, the question here with which the psalmist deals is, do the wicked pay a price for their evil? Do they really pay a price? And what about the righteous? Will they be rewarded? And so there have been times, and there are other psalms. Psalm 73 is another psalm, for example, that deals with this dilemma that sometimes the righteous find themselves in, the dilemma of looking around and seeing that the wicked seem to be doing just fine. They don't make any pretense of serving God, sometimes not even believing there is a God, and yet they seem to do quite well, while the righteous many times suffer? How do you balance that? How do you deal with that? Well, that's really the question here. But the psalmist's advice by inspiration, of course, is do not fret because of evil doers. And the idea of fretting here is really, in the original care, is the idea of becoming angry about this situation. Don't be irritated about this. Don't let this cause you to be angry because of the evildoers. And certainly don't be envious of these workers of iniquity. Don't think that they have something that you really would like to have. Don't let that jealousy take hold here. For they soon shall be cut down. That's verse 2. Like the grass and wither as the green herb. Now, the word soon here in the original really carries the idea of speed or haste. In other words, they're going to be cut down quickly. The idea being that when their end comes, and when God deals with them, it's going to be very sudden and very complete, like the grass that is mowed. There's the beautiful grass, and you mow it, it's gone. It's gone in an instant, is it not? And the green herb, when it's cut off and it has no longer has its source of water that it needs so desperately, it withers very quickly. So the idea there of soon is the idea of how quickly they will be cut off. Their time is coming, in other words. So don't let their situation that seems to be good, while yours may seem to be less than good in terms of some challenges you're facing, even though you're righteous and trying to do what God would have you do, don't let that produce anger, and certainly don't let it make you envious of them. Well, what should you do? Verse 3, trust in the Lord and do good. Trust in the Lord and do good. In other words, you spend your time doing good. And if you'll fill your time with doing good and doing good for others and doing good for the Lord and for His cause, and in our case today, as Christians, obviously, doing good in the work of the church, doing good for others and benevolent deeds and reaching out to others, etc. You spend your time with that and concentrate on that. You won't have much time to think about how the wicked are prospering. And put your trust in the Lord. Dwell in the land, be content with what you have, and notice this, and feed on His faithfulness. Literally, the idea here is feed on truth. Feed on His faithfulness. Trust in the Lord, feed on His truth, recognizing that His Word is truth. And of course, that Word that applies to us today. Of course, the covenant that applies to us today is not the old covenant, but the new covenant, the covenant of Christ. And so we place our faithfulness in that truth, the truth of God's Word. Remember, Jesus said, as recorded in John 8:32, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. And a part of that freedom is freedom from the anxiety and the anger that you might otherwise experience if you spend too much time thinking about how the wicked are prospering. But you feed on the truth. Verse 4 reiterates, really reinforces this admonition of verse 3. Delight yourself also in the Lord. You really spend time making sure that you are doing what you need to do in the Lord and what pleases the Lord. And He shall give you the desires of your heart. But you know, if you are seeking to please the Lord, the desires of your heart are going to be desires that are in harmony with His will. And so you'll get the desires of your heart because the desires you express to God in prayer, as one who has that privilege of prayer, if you're a Christian, those petitions are going to be in harmony with the will of God. John reminds us in one of his epistles that we're to ask according to His will. But if we're delighting in the Lord, we're not going to ask for things that are outside the will of God, because we're going to keep our lives in harmony with the will of God. Well, he goes on in verse 5, commit your way to the Lord, trust also in Him, and He shall bring it to pass. You know, sometimes there are those who will attack us. And frankly, Paul wrote in 2 Timothy 3:12 that if we desire to live godly in Christ Jesus, we'll suffer persecution. Everyone will, to some degree or another, in some form or another. But regardless of what others say about you, if your life is a life that's being lived for the Lord, then God is going to work it all out. You just simply do the right thing and trust God. That's verse 6. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. So you just keep doing the right thing. If you're falsely accused, if you're maligned in a way that obviously is wrong and false, a false accusation on your character, etc., you just make sure you keep doing the right thing and trust the Lord, and ultimately it's going to work out for your good. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Well, then verse 7, and we have to move along. We could spend a lot of time with these wonderful verses. Rest in the Lord. The idea there is be silent. Be silent in the Lord. In other words, just rest. Just rest in the Lord. Be silent and wait patiently for Him. Wait on the Lord. Do not fret because of him who prospers in his way, because of the man who brings wicked schemes to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Do not fret. It only causes harm. You're only going to do yourself harm emotionally and physically if you fret and experience anger over these things with which you should not be concerned, because you've got to leave it in the hands of the Lord. And then again, verse 9, for evildoers shall be cut off, but those who wait on the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. For yet a little while, and the wicked shall be no more. Indeed, you will look carefully for his place, but it shall be no more. God is going to judge all things. But then verse 11, which reminds us of a statement of Jesus in Matthew 5:5, but the meek shall inherit the earth and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. The meek, those who follow God and Christ, the gentle in spirit, those who have that strength under control in following God and in following Christ as Christians today, are going to inherit the truly good things that this life has to offer, and most importantly, the things the next life has to offer, an eternity in heaven.